Okay, in this video, we'll be looking at a posterior ilium. We have done already a series of clips on an anterior ilium, meaning the two innominate bones either going forward or backward in a lesion status. Very often I have found that people who are right-handed often, not always, but often have a tendency to have an anterior ilium and a left posterior if any of the two is in lesion. And that is often because we tend to move forward with our right side if we need to twist, and we go backward with our left side. Of course, it also depends very much on the activities that a person does, like waiters, always either moving from the right side, so often bringing the right ilium forward, and the left ilium back. So, you know, activity and postures are important to consider. Now, the last time in the diagnosis of an anterior ilium, we have done the most basic but most important test, which is the standing test and bending forward. Now, let us say for demonstration purposes that she does have a posterior left ilium. The ilium has moved on the sacrum. Not the sacrum on the ilium, it's the ilium on the sacrum. So, of course, the main test we use is we put our hands on the posterior superior iliac spine area and the sacroiliac joint, and we ask the person, keeping the knees as far as possible straight, to slowly bend forward. So, yeah, slowly just bend forward. Okay, and then come back slowly. Now, it is very interesting because I was not expecting this, but actually she does have a true positive test for a lesion in the left sacroiliac joint. And that is the joint, instead of opening laterally, it tends to ride up. Okay, so it means the ilium is not separating easily to allow the flexion from the sacrum, but the two tend to remain what we would call in lay terms stuck, so that you feel that the joint, the sacroiliac joint, is riding upwards. So this is the most important test for to know that there is a problem in the sacroiliac area on the left. So we have seen in the first part, when I diagnosed her problem in the left sacroiliac joint while standing, the standing seat, flexion. Now we are going to have a look at her supine. And one of the most main tests as well, while they are supine, is for leg length. And normally what I do first to relax the pelvis, just put her knees up, then I ask her to lift her pelvis just a little bit and then down and really relax it. Bring her legs forward, shake them a little bit. You can also, for major accuracy, just do a little bit this movement to further relax the area. And bring the legs down. And lo and behold, her left leg is shorter. You also sometimes check that there are no anatomical discrepancies. It could be shorter because of a slightly shorter tibia or femur, which is not the case with her. And also, I have to add, when we did the standing test and there was a problem on the left side, her PSIS, posterior superior iliac spine, was also a bit lower. Okay, I failed to mention that. It was a little bit lower down. So a shorter leg, a lower down PSIS, inferior, okay? Then let's check the anterior superior iliac spine here of the pelvis. And again, very ticklish. I have to say that with many patients, this area can be very ticklish. I was chatting, I wasn't paying enough attention, because that's one thing I always say in all my videos, be always very relaxed, breathing gently, and very attentive. So I just went a little bit too much like that. Normally, it doesn't create discomfort in most people, but it does with her. So let's start again. Now making contact with the anterior superior iliac spine. Is that better? Mm-hmm. Yeah, good. And definitely the left one is superior. So here we have three important signs of a posterior left ilium, because we have an inferior posterior PSIS on the left behind, a superior ASIS again in the front, and a shorter leg. So these are very important signs. And also I must add that normally, we did only the standing test, but normally I would do as well the sitting down test when they bend forward, and we'll look at it in a next video, to make sure as well that there is no some sacral involvement, because when they sit down, they stabilize the ischial tuberosity and the main movement comes from the sacrum. But as I said, we will see this in a clip which is coming soon. But at the moment being, let's concentrate on this left posterior iliac spine or ilium. And we are going to look now at some techniques, gentle techniques, to start relaxing the area, and then to some correction movements with muscle energy and as well with a high velocity technique.